You love Slim Martin, don't you?
Yes.
Would you lie for him?
Objection. Objection sustained.
Shorty Miller testified that Slim Martin sent you away from the ranch. He said, get her out of here fast. Had you quarreled with Martin?
Yes, but it...
Was Mrs. Ames the subject of your quarrel?
Well...
Yes or no?
Well, something she said... Look, Judge, I can't say yes or no. It don't make sense that way.
The witness will answer the question.
Was Mrs. Ames the subject of your quarrel, yes or no?
Oh, haven't you any sense at all? Slim didn't do it. That woman made Mr. Ames so unhappy he didn't want to live, that's all. That's the truth, and I'm trying to tell you.
Miss Revere?
Your Honor, I submit to you.
You shut up and let me talk. Your Honor, now I'm going to tell. Nobody told the truth. Not Slim or me or anybody. But I don't care what anybody said. This is the truth. This is really the truth. He wasn't in that room when Mr. Ames died. He was with me. He wouldn't say so because he was trying to protect me. But that's where he was. I tell you, he was with me all the time.
Maisie, stop it.
Let me tell. I don't care who knows now. I won't let him kill you.
Maisie, they'll jail you. That's perjury. Don't believe her, Your Honor. She's lying to save me, but I won't let her.
Your Honor, in all my years...
Your Honor, I...
Graves, I have never counted.
Order! Order! Order in this courtroom or I'll have the room cleared.
Hey, mister. Where do you think you're going?
It's not usual.
No, you can't go in there.
I'll explain.
Wait.
Your Honor, I am Mr. Bannerman of the firm of Badham, Burke, and Caldwell, New York City.
But, my dear sir, this court is in session.
I realize that, Your Honor, but I'm in possession of a letter which may be relevant to this case. My firm are the attorneys for the late Clifford Ames.
Your Honor, I object to the way the defense...
Go on, Mr. Bannerman.
4 days after Mr. Ames' death, we received a letter dated and mailed on the day of his death. I have it here.
Well, this merely mentions an enclosure. A letter to Miss Maisie Revere.
I have that also. We've been trying to locate Miss Revere. I thought at first this letter might be purely personal. My only instructions from my client were to deliver the letter unopened. I feel now, however, that it may be related to this case, since Miss Revere is a witness here.
Your Honor, this is highly irregular.
Oh, I'm aware of that. Stand down, Miss Revere.
Get down from here, you mean?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
You will open and read that letter. If it has no bearing on the case, you will resume the stand and this trial will continue.
Yes, sir.
Your Honor, instruct this woman not to destroy this letter. It may contain evidence for the prosecution.
Well, who's destroyed anything? I'm only trying to get it open. Please excuse me, Judge, for being so clumsy. My nails are kind of long, you see. I've been working in a manicure shop, and sometimes the men like it that way. I've been trying to do the best. It says it here. Look, here it is. He killed himself. Look, Slimmy, darling, he says it here. He killed himself.
Show it to his Honor.
Oh, look right here.
I ask Your Honor's permission to put Mr. Bannerman on the stand to swear that that is Mr. Ames' handwriting.
The clerk will first read the letter.
Your Honor, the state has had no opportunity
to... The clerk will read the letter.
Barrow Ranch. Dear Maisie, I think you understand better than anyone else how things are with me. I know now that I can never live and rid myself of the love I have for my wife. She married me for my money. She never loved me. But tonight I'll be free of it. It's a coward's way, perhaps, but the only way for me. I'm leaving you the ranch and enough money to keep you in opera-length hose for the rest of your life. I have to put it in legal language. But first, let me say it very simply. You're to have the ranch and plenty of money to run it. I hope you and Slim will live on the ranch and be happy there. I love you both.
Slim, you're free.
Your Honor, the state moves that the indictment against the defendant Charles Martin be dismissed.
Motion granted.
Well, fella, looks like it's back to the ranch for you.
Well, I don't know about that. The place has changed hands. If I still got my job, Maisie, I can cook or wash dishes.
Well, we've a China boy to do that. But I can give you a nice job as husband. What do you say, honey?
This is what I say.